Everything was calm and peaceful, but they started attacking us and they started shooting at us.
Principal protesters, you were.
We did nothing, but they started
arresting us.
They did bring
my phone and stolen. Has been stolen by the Nigerian policeman. When they robbed me, they robbed me, they slapped me.
Why exactly did you come out to protest?
I came out for this country to be a better country because we are tired. We are tired of oppression. We are tired of killing. We are tired of our leadership sponsoring the terrorists. You know, we want a better Nigeria. We want them to change this country for a better Nigeria so that our future, our generation can benefit from it. We want a better Nigeria. Let them change this country for good. That's why I'm here.
So, did they arrest you? What did they tell you?
I did nothing. It was a peaceful protest. But suddenly they came at us, they started shooting tear gas at us, and before we know it, they started chasing us up and down. And before you know it, I was somewhere there, and the policemen came to beat me, and they started beating me, they beat me mercilessly, before they took me into the Black Maria. But suddenly, I never know what happened, they just said, we should go.
All right, man.
The police wanted to confine us to that space. The fair was not too safe for us. I mean, it's middle of nowhere. But they said there are hoodlums there. But we believe all Nigerians are partakers in the sovereignty of the land right now. As far as we are concerned, the hoodlums are products. They were made hoodlums by this system. So we don't recognize hoodlums. But we always insist that our protest must be peaceful. Our statement must be made very strongly, but in a very peaceful manner. Because when you allow it to degenerate, it distracts attention from what you actually say. So our motive and purpose for coming out this morning was very clear. That June 12, 1993 marked a signal point in our history when our people rejected military rule by coming out to vote en masse for a civilian administration. They did not just, it was not about the face of the contestant that won, that they liked. It was about kicking out military despotism and autocracy and corruption for which the NDB administration was renowned. The promise of June 12, 1993 was that we will have a democracy which will allow for participation. Not just for the ritual of voting every 4 years. Participation in the sense that all Nigerians will be able to access quality education, will be able to access water supply, will be able to access all the good things of life. But unfortunately, the struggle that started in 1993 and terminated with Abacha's death in late 97, and then Absalom had to quickly, under pressure from civil groups, how to quickly rush a transition program handed over in 1999. That struggle has been hijacked. Because those who won the elections progressively since 1999 have committed 100-fold all the crimes which Nigeria came out to reject on June 12, 1993. All the crimes of the military. Today, just like in the days of the military, people are disappearing in hundreds and thousands. There is massive insecurity all over the land. And it is through the politicians. It was the governor of Borno State that harmed Boko Haram. And we all know it, but we pretend not to know it. He harmed Yusuf, who started Boko Haram. And today they cannot contain it. It was politicians that harmed the militants in Niger Delta that started busting pipelines and destroying the ecosystem in that place, kidnapping for ransom and so on. It was a governor of Kwara State. When armed robbers were caught, they said they were talks to Governor Saraki. In Lagos State here, Agberos are also empowered to extort money from us every day on the streets and to rig elections. So the politicians have violated the basic principles of democracy.
They have not even allowed any breath that we allow Nigerians to thrive and to fulfill their purpose. So as a result of that, we all can see the result.
Let me bridge you here, sir. Can you talk about your demands?
Our demands are clear. But something must lead to the demands. 300 government enterprises have been privatized. They said privatized, I said stolen. Worth trillions of dollars. These companies were taken over by the same politicians and their fronts, scrapped, and people became instant billionaires. While millions of workers were rendered jobless. We pass a situation where because of their ruinous economic policies, thousands of enterprises have actually closed down and people are jobless. Nigerian youth are coming out of universities and colleges without any promise of even the least paying job. We are saying that this situation cannot remain. It's unacceptable. Now, to make matters worse, because the least we can do in this situation is at least to talk. But they say we can't talk, they ban Twitter. And there is an increasing repression and clampdown on free speech. Those of us who are witnesses to June 12th, who fought the struggle that lasted almost 10 years, from 93 to 98, until military departed, we will not open our eyes and they will subvert the essence of the struggle of June 12th. So today is important to us because we remember what we struggled for. That what we want is quality education for Nigerian youth. But today the educational sector is in shambles because of poor funding. Nigeria is renowned all over the world for spending the least amount of money on healthcare services. Our hospitals have become mortuaries. This cannot be allowed to continue. I'm not talking to government. My clarion call is to all Nigerians to come out and conquer fear. Let them come out in their multitude and begin to speak out and begin to act, begin to take action. We oppose any form of hate speech. We oppose those who are campaigning on behalf of ethno-religious irredentism. Because we know some of them are sponsored by the same politicians. And when they destroy everything, these people will take their jet and fly out. We have nowhere to go. This is our country. We are appealing to all Nigerians. Whether you are Fulani or not, it's not the average Fulani does not know what is going on. The average Fulani is oblivious of what is happening in Abuja, in Abuja. Some of the SMA are even employed by Southerners. So let us cease ethnicizing this crisis. This crisis is not about ethnicity. The people who destroy Nigeria are from all over Nigeria. And all of us must also unite.
That one of the statements from some of the protesters were gathered here this morning to protest for Ojota, Lagos. Lots of youths gathered this morning to protest on top the way they say government, they lead them, and on top the policies where they say no, they okay with them for Nigeria, where they won't make a change. And initially, the area been day camp with over 30 police trucks and vans. We've been there, the area, and the youth been no day. But all of a sudden, the youth just appear from nowhere, begin the protest, and the police had to use tear gas to scatter them, and also begin the use. They begin the shoot for up. They no shoot at anybody. We no see anybody where they shoot for here. But we witness tear gas. Even me, where they talk, the tear gas enter my eye, enter my nose. So the tears begin to run. They come out. And then police begin to arrest some of them. But one thing we will notice, we say, as police arrest some of them, police come later, begin free people where they arrest. They don't disperse the whole crowd where they gather. Just in a matter of 5 minutes, they use tear gas, disperse them, pursue all of them, everybody run through way. Nobody be here again. And as it be now only police presence will they see for everywhere. You know, they see the protesters again as all of them run, enter different places. And the people where they say they arrest, they don't free all of them. We just see them, all of them, they don't free them. They go back. We never know whether the youths go regroup or not. But the situation here, we say, people still gather and areas still get tensed. Areas still get tensed. Lots of people gathering by the side of the roads. I don't know if they want to regroup again or not. But now inside this van, they've been put all the people in the arrest. And just a couple of minutes, this man will be talk to us to secure the arrest. They are released. They see more of police trucks still arriving.
Only those ones. Few Nigerians can feed even once or twice a day properly. And when you are
different. So, come. What really happened to you?
Can you believe that we are just protesting him peacefully? This is my own van, as you can see. We are just protesting peacefully, and police people are just coming behind us, shooting tear gas, and we just want for our life. So, we are running, see, they arrest me. See, you can see my clothes, you can see my hand with blood. It's the police people that want me like this. They are one of my colleagues, the policemen who is from here. We didn't recognize the policeman.
So, what do you want to tell them when make them release on her?
I don't know what his name, but I know Chunde is the name of that policeman that I say we should get down. So he's the one I say we should get down. Like, someone called me, maybe the IG or somebody just called me. That's why we get down for him.
So, we're going to still continue the protest today?
Okay. Take it back. No, all going right. Back.
Thank you. That was one of the protesters who I just spoke to, Nanana, and he tell me, say, they will still continue to protest. They don't tell me how they take release arm, despite the way they take my handle and tear in clothes, and how can get inside the, till they call inside the Black Maria will be for the back there. For now, everywhere don't calm down, but we'll still be here live. We'll be bringing on more updates if anything erupt again. All the young boys. All the young boys will really come out, don't clear out, and place their camp for the meantime. So we'll go sit here to bring on more updates if any other thing erupt for this area. But for now, here don't they come. Nothing much they happen now. Only police trucks full everywhere. Police trucks everywhere, policemen everywhere with guns, different kinds of guns. What happened to this man? Now some of those protesters, if they come back to go meet police this time, then even grill run again. Lots and lots of police trucks all over the place, moving from here and there.
So we went to last year coming. Last year they registered more than 88 political parties. Any party that belongs to youth, last year they registered them. If Tinubu is sure, let him come out and face us at election without regain. It will be well with them. Yeah. At the end of the day, they have the power, they can molest us, they can embarrass us on the street.
We are not them.
Let police know that we are fighting for them. We are fighting for the police. Look at them, they buy uniform with their own money. If they are transferred from Lagos to anywhere,
they buy guns from the
adverts. Enough is enough. This is the time Nigerian students, Nigerian LDRCW must come out. If you are collecting 500 at election, shame unto you. They are buying your life with 500 naira. They are buying 4 years out of your life with 1,000 naira. Enough is enough. We are non-violent protesters.
Yo, and a 20 naira.
20 naira, imagine. So the Coco, they said the protesters, some of them still come back. They don't even send police this time. They come to the talk to the press. They tell press why they gather. See, they don't even send, and whatever will happen, make it happen. Police arrest, teams still they move around. So this set of protesters, no send. They just come here straight. Begin the protest in front of police. They talk to the press. They tell press waiting. They tell the press what thing they carry for mind and why they protest. And they say the protest continues no matter what thing happens. And so they let the fear who will arrest them and who won't arrest them. Because so many of their people don't run, come out. So we day here, we will continue to the day here until whenever the whole matter here is settled.
This is revolution now. It is time for him to leave.
I must go.
We must go.
What is going on?
Instead of using them as surveillance against peaceful protesters, what is a shame to Nigeria?
Very big shame.
What is a big shame to Nigeria? Take it or leave it.
Just so you know, if you didn't listen to us or they watch this video, make you know say every one of the comments where the protesters they make now their own personal opinion, they are none of our own opinion from the BBC. Our own to show now within they happen here will be the protest waiting on and police don't try to disperse. Many of them will be gathered and just a few of them will defy police presence and still stay around. They talk, they say different things. Meanwhile, your good maker still remind you, say, today's our June 12th protest, Nasik of today, the day when they celebrate as Democracy Day for Nigeria. All about the day where they've been doing election for 1993. June 12th, the election where government declared the winner, say, the winner, no win again. So there was a wuru-wuru inside the election. We make them come stop the whole protest and all that. We make them stop the whole election, cancel and imprison the person who been win because he declared himself winner. And all that and all that. The man NKO Abiola and Nasek of NKO Abiola will later die for prison. Now he make in the southwest part of Nigeria, in the August of 1912. As a day to honor NKO Abiola on top high intake, they fight to get Nigeria back to democracy and later die in prison. And later when Mr. Buhari become president of Nigeria, he come convert June 12 to mean the man, the men democracy day.
Baba Fifunwa, Lofe Lofe, Baba Fifunwa, education, Tawanson Wofu. Lofe, lofe, baba fifunwa. See, let me tell you one thing. Everything in this country is not totally okay. Now, gari is expensive. Fiota is 20 naira. Even though my school fees, I can't even afford to pay it. So, why am I not going to come out to protest? Even though I'm even hungry right now, as I'm telling you, because I don't have money to eat. Let me tell you one thing, this country is bullshit. So that's why we need to come out to protest, to clamor for what we are feeling, our pain, to make them understand that if it is restructuring, restructured. The constitution, if not to change, change them. Things are not going well. How can someone embezzle about a billion? No be safe with that. So that's why we need to come out to protest. If you are out there or in your house, you're not coming out to protest. My brother, sorry to
say. Let's stop to this time. Go then.
Lofe, Baba Fifuwa. Lofe, Lofe, Baba Fifuwa. Education, Tawas or Wofu. Lofe, Lofe, Baba Fifuwa. Oh, yeah, Bangida, Nada, Piwa, Bangida, Nada, Piwa. What do we do there? We do the nothing, no. What do we do there? We do them nothing, no. See, the education is free, we are paying for it, fine. But life is not easy for us. As a Nigerian, life is not easy for us as a Nigerian. Let me be sincere with you. Now, Gary is expensive. Piota is expensive. Now, I can't even afford to buy Piota for one Piota for myself because I want to survive. So I need to be taking just a normal tank water now. And right now, my health does not allow me to be taking just ordinary water, but I have to be taking it because I need to be okay. But let me make you understand one thing, as a Nigerian, we are tired. That's why we are out here to clamor for our pain, our hunger, to make them understand that we are not just here for fun. We are here for real work, to make them understand that our life is at stake with hunger. Our life is at stake with pain, with anger, insecurities in the country. Nobody can move from here to Aba now. Nobody can move here to Idogo now. And yesterday, there was still a lot of things that was still happening at Idogo here. So that's why we need to come out to clamor. Even now, the structure, if it is the change of the constitution, change them. See, this life is not easy, my brother. So that's why we are out here for the protest. Thank you.
So we have this kind of police people in Lagos, and they are robbing people every day at Third Mainland Bridge. Look at the number of police here. Police are more than 200 here. Go to Third Mainland Bridge every night, they are robbing people. There is no police. For example, where did you go? That man is
where did you go?
We don't need it. We don't want it. Very long at that Nigeria. Long at that Nigeria. We don't need it.
We gave him first.
Okay, we will take on to other locations where protests happen for Nigeria, and after that we will still come back to Lagos to give them more updates. For now, the protests don't reduce small as police don't disperse the protesters, and we will still stay here to give them an update as they happen. Only police presence and just a few number of young men will gather here and then stay here for now. So, Mona, still stick to us because more videos they come from other parts of Nigeria where the protests they go on.